Tired of juggling GoDaddy, Namecheap, and a dozen other tools just to keep your businesses online? With HIGHLEVEL, you can set up, manage, and transfer domains. Plus, set up websites, funnels, and courses. You can do all of this in one place without ever leaving the HIGHLEVEL platform. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to do every single one of these step by step. So the first thing I want to do is break down what a domain is in as simple language as possible. So a domain really is just an identifier of your site, and subdomains and extensions are just basic ways to categorize your site. So a subdomain is anything that comes before the name, which is the domain. So you could have courses high level, you could have help high level, you could have happiness, whatever you want. You can put the subdomain first, okay, and then that will be added in. And that's the subdomain. You can change that multiple times for a domain, okay? But you can't have multiple domains for a subdomain, but you can have multiple subdomains for a domain. A domain is the thing itself. So go high level, Declan the Wizard, Amazon.com. It's just going to be the name of the thing. Then the extension is the last part, which is .com, .co, .ai, whatever you want, you can slap that in there. So that is essentially what a domain is. If you guys have any questions at all, drop them down in the comments and I'll answer as fast as possible. Now we're going to go into setting up domains, transferring them, and doing all this other stuff so you can get everything you want in high level live ASAP. So to access domains and that whole part inside of high level, you're going to come into your sub account, you're going to go right down to settings and you're going to scroll to domains and URL redirects. Don't worry, we will cover URL redirects after we cover domains. So in here, you will see three different options. Okay, number one, you can purchase a domain. So that is buying and acquiring a domain. Number two, you can transfer a domain, which is bringing in from GoDaddy, Namecheap, Squarespace, wherever you have it, you can plug it into high level. Then number three, we have connecting a domain, which is where it will stay on another registrar, but it'll be connected to high level so you can use it. And we're going to go over all three. So first up, we are going to purchase a domain. So you're going to click that button. You're going to come right in here and you're going to type in the name of the domain you want. So what we're going to do is we're going to do Declan the Wizard. Then we're going to do .com because you can put in your extensions. So we're going to click search. Remember the extension we talked about that earlier? And you can see, huzzah, it's available. How cool is that? But you can also see down here all the other options with the other extensions. So .com, we have .me, .org, .tech. I mean, you see it just goes on with a bunch of random stuff. .com is pretty much the standard. It's the best, but you can always get other ones like .ai or stuff like that. And to do that, you would just come in here and say, I want .ai if it's not available. And then you search that and then you will see right there. So that's kind of expensive. So you see how the prices kind of change for certain stuff. AI is hot right now, so it costs a little more. But basic things are all pretty much the same price per year. They're not per month, per year. So it's like 12 bucks a year for most domains, which is really cheap. So then we pick the exact one we wanted, which was .com. So we're going to search this. Then we're going to come right in here. We see, okay, this looks good. And we're going to click buy. Now, this is what we want to do. We want to be very careful because they have a lot of add-ons here. Okay, because you see right here, it says protect your brand from competitors. You don't need all those. Now, you could if you wanted, if you really think it's important, but you want to unclick these and you see how the price goes down. And then you would pick it for how long you want it. So for SEO purposes, the longer you have it, it does help a bit. But if you're just testing out, get it for 1 year and it's $12 for the entire year. Then from there, you come right in here and you click agree. And then you click pay $12. And then you will now have the domain. Once it goes through, it'll go through the loading screen. It'll show you that you have it. You then can come right back here and you will see your domain popped up. Now, real quick, because I want to cover everything. If you don't see a way to purchase a domain in here and you're like, where is it? It's not on my screen, but it's on Declan's. Go back to agency view, okay, which is this side. Come down to settings and go to domain purchase. And then here you can toggle it on or off for your accounts. Then that's how it's going to pop up. So make sure you do that if you don't see it. Very, very important. We'll get into rebilling later, so don't worry about that. Okay, so that's how we purchase a domain. That's how you buy it. So very simple. Okay, we have transfer in a domain, which is a little more complicated. This is how we're going to take a domain from GoDaddy, Namecheap, wherever, and bring it into high level so it's now officially in high level forever. So let's come in here, and we're going to transfer this domain right in here. So you put in whatever domain you want to move from your other extension. So we're going to do this. We're going to click continue. Then right here, it's going to immediately identify the domain, where it's from, their current registration, all that extra stuff, the price, which is really cool. So it immediately has that. So then we're going to click continue. So then you have two different options. You can upload the DNS zone file, which you're going to need to, or you can scan the records, which is going to go through and scan it. Now, every domain registrar is a little different. Okay. I'm going to show you the basics on GoDaddy because that's what I use, but it's going to change depending on what you're doing. Okay. Because different registrars are different, but it's all in the same place. It's DNS managed. It's the same rubric, so to speak. So then you'd come into GoDaddy, whatever you're using. Okay. Go to DNS, come right down here, click actions. Again, you can just ChatGPT this if you're trying to find stuff, but you would just click export zone file and it's going to download it. Then you come right in here, you click upload and you upload that exact file that just went in. So very simple. You can do that. Or you can click the scan records, which is going to go through and just scan the current DNS records to make sure everything is good. Okay. From there we go. Yay. These are all awesome. You check it. If you like it and everything is the way you want it to be, remember, you can always use ChatGPT to find exactly where this stuff is because it always changes. We come right down here once we like the way everything looks and we're going to click I confirm and, you know, cross-checked and all this other jazz. Then we're going to click continue. Then what you're going to do is you're going to come right in, go to your domain, scroll down, click transfer new registrar. It'll be right under your domain and whatever server you have, you just click it, scroll to the bottom and you'll see transfer domain. Once you come in here, you click continue. Okay. And then right here, what you're going to get is you're going to get here to get your authorization code. Then we're going to click it. And then you're going to take this, you're going to copy it, you're going to come right back in here and you're going to paste this code right in here. Then you're going to click confirm and finalize transfer. And then right in here, you're going to go through waiting or pending approval and then you're good to go. So you just have to follow this process. It is a bit tricky to find that EEP code, okay, which is the thing we just did. So what I recommend you do, since every domain registrar is different, is you go to ChatGPT and you figure out where to find the EEP code. Watch a video on it because everyone is different and it changes. It's roughly always in the same place, which is when you transfer a domain, it'll be right under there. So that's relatively easy, but it depends on what you're doing, or you can drop a comment down below and I'll try to help aid you through it. It is relatively easy. You just got to find it. So once we're there, we just wait and make sure everything is good and make sure your domain is good. Once it is approved though, we would go back to domains and you would see it just like this right in here and it's ready to go. This has not been fully done because it has to be approved and we have to go through on the other side of GoDaddy. But from there, we are then good to go and it's in our account. So now we move on to the last part with the domains, which is connecting a domain. So this is just bringing a domain in here. It's not transferring. It's adding in a high level so you can use it for other things. And you can pick exactly what you want it to connect to. But for right now, we want to just connect it and bring it in. So what we're going to do is we're going to come back into GoDaddy. Okay, we're going to copy and paste the domain, or you can just type it in just like that. We're going to come right in here. We're going to click paste, and then we're going to click continue. From here, because it's with GoDaddy, you can just click continue and it's going to do it automatically, which is really cool. Now you might have to change some stuff, but manually is just going in and tweaking it the other way, which is adding in records. So then we click authorize domain. Once that looks good, we click connect. Then it will say David's Plumbing & Sons is now a lead connector domain. So we come back here, we wait for this to authorize. Sometimes it doesn't go through, but if it never does, it's because of the DNS records aren't properly configured, which there's a way to add it manually, which when you click it, it'll tell you exactly what to add. So that's how you connect the domain. Now, just to give you a quick update on the manual version. We come in here, we paste this right here, we click continue. You just click this right here and you click add records manually and it tells you exactly what to add and you just add them into the DNS records. You create the A record, you create the host, the required value, and then you are good to go. And if you want me to take an even step further, if it's confusing, I will just quickly show you. So we have A record, you would come in, you would click add new record, you would choose A. Very simple, you follow record A, host, we come in here, we go name, which is, that is the host, which we would put is at, we do at, and then you come right in here and you type this exact code, okay, and you'd paste it right here, which is the value, and then you click save. So that's how you do it manually. And guys, I'm just showing you, but it's so simple. You just go, okay, record, cool, and you just add it, and the next one would be CNAME. So you come and you'd add another record and you call it CNAME. Very simple. It doesn't get any easier than that, but that's how you would do it manually if it doesn't properly go through. So that's just to show you to make sure you have it. Again, any questions you have, drop them down below. So now once you have your domain connected in here, there's a couple really important things things to note. So if you've transferred a domain, which we technically did, but it takes a while to get here, so we have to go through the approval, but we haven't done that. We followed all the steps. We could click approve, but I don't want this domain here. It's just a test. If you connect it, what we just did, via your other domain register, transferring, you will not be able to access the DNS. So if you own the domain or you've fully transferred it, when you click manage, you will be able to access the DNS records in here. If you have just connected it, you still have to go through your other registrar like GoDaddy to access the DNS. So that's a really important fact to know. And again, when you click manage, you'll see it here, but you also see what it's connected to. So this is not connected to anything, but you can see, oh wow, it's connected to this, connected to that. And then you can click connect and add it into your email, WordPress, all that stuff, which we're gonna get into in a sec. But just to let you know, you click manage and that's how you would see where it's at. So that kind of gives you a full scope. So you can always come back here to domains and URL redirects and you can have access to this so you can edit it. Okay, so now it's time to show you how to connect this to a website, a funnel, a community, whatever you want. But before we jump into that, okay, I just want to let you know, if you are interested more in High Level, more about learning this entire process, I have a 30-day free trial link down below of High Level. When you sign up with that, you get access to a ton of amazing goodies, okay? And when I say goodies, I mean access to a private community, access to all of these different training modules, snapshots, sales scripts, AI prompts, trainings on how to master High Level, trainings on how to sell High Level. I mean, literally all the trainings you could possibly need. 5 live coaching calls you can attend every single week right in here. You just click it, hop on Zoom. I'm in one of them, and so much more. So you can get all of your questions answered and all the handholding you need. And guys, this $10,000 worth of free bonuses, all of this stuff, the calls, the trainings, the community, all of this is free when you sign up with that link down below. Now, if you already have High Level and you still are interested in joining, there's another link you can click right below the other one that will take you through a process for you to join otherwise. But guys, if you're new to High Level or you want to sign up with me, go down below and you'll get access to all of this stuff for free. And you can message me anytime you want so I can help you one-on-one. Simple as that, guys. It is very straightforward, but you get access to so much stuff for signing up with that link down below. So to connect a website or really anything you want, you can just come right into Manage and click Connect. And right here, it's going to show you all of the different options you can get. So to connect a website, you can come right here, click Connect Email. You just follow the steps. I mean, it's so easy that you just click and follow along. Like for example, Client Portal, if you want to access the courses, you click Connect and it's going to take you to the Client Portal side. Then you just put in your domain right here and click add domain and then you're good to go. It's so straightforward. It tells you exactly what to do and that's how you can connect it to multiple different things. Now there is another way to connect the websites. Now the easiest way is what I just showed you where you go in and you click connect website. But if you come in here and let's say we like Declan Snapshot under funnels, we can just click edit right here. Okay. Then we can click settings. Then we can also click domain and just click it, come down and click save. And then you have a domain added in just like that. And you can do the same thing right up here in websites. If we say, okay, we want Novash Real Estate, we're going to click this right here, go right to settings, click domain, click it, and you're good to go. So that is another way to add it just to let you know. So it's very simple, guys. It's extremely straightforward. I mean, anyone can do this. High Level makes it so easy. And if you guys have any questions, drop a comment down below so I can guide you. But that way, immediately when you come in, you can come in and you can start adding your domain to your websites and make everything live very, very quickly. Okay, so one of the last things I want to show you before we jump into URL redirects is a sneaky little way to make extra money, and that is rebilling on your domain. So if you come to Agency View and you click into a sub account, okay, that you own and control, and guys, this is on the $497 plan, but if we come right in here to rebilling, you can actually come down and you'll see domain purchase. So if you click this, the guys, again, $497 plan, you got to have that one, but you can actually mark up the price when someone buys a domain, so you make a little extra money. Now, this is really great if they're going to be buying domains through your account anyway. Again, you don't want to make it absurd. You obviously want to tell them, but you can have them buy a domain and then you can charge them an extra $2. So every year you're making that extra $2. Doesn't seem like a lot, but when you got hundreds of sub accounts, rebilling adds up really quickly. So that's how you would come in and you would add the rebilling side of things. You can just play with this however you want. Obviously, always tell people be transparent, but you can dial in exactly how much you want to charge for them to buy domains under you. And guys, really great way to make some extra money. Again, I know it doesn't seem like a lot, but all of this rebilling, it adds up drastically. And if you are interested in rebilling, you're like, that's awesome. Watch the video on my channel that goes in depth on that because this is a game changer if you are an agency. All right, so now that you understand everything about domains in High Level, how to transfer, connect, buy, all that good stuff, we now want to go into URL redirects. This is an awesome feature. This can be very handy. All this does is when someone types in your URL, so www.declanisamazing.com, it then could send them to amazon.com or whatever. It can just redirect them to another URL. So to do a URL redirect, we're going to click add a redirect. You're going to select the exact domain you want in your account. Remember, you can have multiple domains in your account. You're going to click this right here or whatever domain you want. Then you're going to put in the path. The path is what comes after this. Now, technically, you could just have it right after, but that would be really bad because then your website's going to another website, which you could do with a regular domain, but you want to add a path. So we're going to do /money. Okay, just say we created that extra path, which you just create through a website page. And then you're going to want URL as the redirect type. Then we're going to put in the target URL. So what's the target URL going to be? It's going to be matrimont.com. So now check this out. Anytime someone types David Plumley and Son /money in, it's going to go right to here. So let's experiment. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to come right on over to Google. We're going to type in this right here. Then we're going to do /money. Actually, you know what's even better? Let's just put this right up here. We're going to click enter. Look at that. It now goes ching to a different URL by just typing in that one thing. So it's super cool. Guys, you can do that with really any URL you're trying to shift to. And this can be really handy if you have multiple domains that you want pointing to one website. You can increase your traffic like crazy. So guys, that's how you do URL redirects. I showed you, I typed it in for you. I proved it for you. It's awesome. I definitely recommend you play with it because it is something that add a lot of extra traffic and make things much smoother in your process. And it's one of those little features in High Level that a lot of people don't use or know about. And I just showed you how to use it. So make sure you utilize it. So guys, thank you so much for watching. If you guys have any questions, drop a comment down below. I answer very quickly. And if you are interested in High Level, check out that 30-day, not 14-day, but exclusive 30-day free trial link down below because you're going to get access to a lot of awesome bonuses for free and 30 days of High Level. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a video. It's going to pop up right in the screen. That's going to be the website tutorial in High Level. I recommend you check it out. It's going to go in depth on this. And what better thing to go over after learning domains than websites? So make sure you check that out. Watch it. It's going to blow you away. So again, drop a comment down below. Check out the link if you're interested. And make sure you watch the video that pops up at the end of the screen.